Welcome to a new video of the Parts channel. Well, I recently made a video about oil inside the expansion tank or coolant tank, and well, there are people who have had some doubts. Well, I'm going to dig a little deeper on the subject. If you find oil in the coolant tank, you have to differentiate if the vehicle is diesel or the vehicle is gasoline. Why? Let's see. If it is diesel, turbo diesel actually have a part called the oil water cooler. I'll leave the link there so you can see what that part is. Gasoline does not usually carry that part, except for some model that I saw a long time ago, an Audi turbo gasoline, the cooler, but the vast majority of gasoline does not have it. Well, let's see. If it is a diesel vehicle, the problem that there is oil there may be for several reasons. First, because that part fails, which is usually the most normal thing. In fact, that pipe fails, it starts over time. So when it withstands so much heat in there, in that piece both water and oil circulate, they do not mix, they are separated by very thin sheets of aluminum, and sometimes a crack occurs, and then they mix and the oil enters into the liquid and mixes with the cooling liquid and would reach the expansion vessel, and it is detected there to find out that it is usually seen that oil enters inside, but the system does not have pressure, it does not pick up pressure. Another problem that may exist is that there is oil inside and the system has pressure, then it no longer has anything to do with the oil cooler water, so we are already talking about a problem that would be common in gasoline and diesel, which would be cylinder head gasket or cylinder head. If it picks up pressure, it is usually a problem with the cylinder head gasket, in this case both in gasoline and diesel, because if there is a problem with the cylinder head gasket and the oil and water come into contact with the combustion chamber, there are excess pressure, because there it would tend to evaporate directly, especially the water, then excess pressure would be created, because when water is in contact with these temperatures, its molecules separate, as when it boils, and we would have that problem. But there is a third case also, which can occur, is not so common but it also occurs. And that third case would be that oil enters here, it can be gasoline and also in some diesel, but I already said that it is not so common, but not there is no pressure. Sometimes you notice a loss of power, fumes that come out of the exhaust, both black smoke, like white smoke, especially white, is that you already know the water vapor that comes out through the exhaust pipe, but as I say, sometimes none of that happens. But it continues to enter the expansion tank, there is still oil, and that is usually a problem with a cylinder head. I have seen this has been this week on Monday or Tuesday, a vehicle that had that problem, a 1600.